Hi, I'm the Rap Critic, telling you the top 5 worst lyrics I've ever heard this month. Now, when I make these lists, I always make it consist of songs that I've heard this month, not necessarily songs that came out this month, just to clear that up. So, let's get started.
Have a baby by me, baby, be a millionaire. Have a baby by me, baby, be a millionaire. Have a baby by me, baby, be a millionaire. Be a millionaire.
You know, it's not that this is sampling a song that 50 Cent himself made not even 2 years before this one came out.
Have a baby by me, baby. Be a millionaire. I write the check before the baby comes. Who the hell cares?
But it's just the fact that he seems way too eager to invite women to extort him for child support. He might as well say, hey, you want $1 million and I don't want to use a condom. Let's help each other out. Ugh, just saying that made my soul cringe.
You think about me?
Alright, look. It's not like I hate the fact that 50 Cent all of a sudden started focusing on love and sex songs, because honestly, I'd rather hear that from him than hear about him pulling in 7 figures a year, yet still talking about how he's robbing and killing people and selling drugs on the street. Yeah, after you sign a deal with Vitamin Water, it kinda makes the hardcore image a little hard to uphold. But man, could you at least be realistic about this? I mean, the song's musical atmosphere is a love song where he's talking to his girl, and he starts it like this.
You think about money when you think about me, huh?
Sounds like true love, doesn't it?
That's why my ex, you don't wanna be her. I had her eating lobster, now she eat pizza.
Are you talking about your ex while on a date with your current girl? Well, I guess if you do it right, you can kinda
think about Easter when I think about Keisha. Sure to stay fly, that's why I keep her.
You keep her? Like you're still with this girl. And you're telling this to the girl that you're currently on a date. This is not realistic!
I love the way you dress. Now take it off.
God, I'm so tired of this. Especially when there's a music video involved where the rapper's talking to the girl and she's taking it like it's the most flattering thing she's ever heard. Can we please have a video where the girl realistically reacts to what the rapper is saying?
Goddamn, girl. We used to be friends.
Huh. Well then.
We can do anything. Walk into anywhere and buy anything. Chillin', I ain't worried about anything. Why stop now? I can have everything.
Question, are you mad about the fact that you can have anything? Because you certainly don't sound happy about it. You think this would be kind of a joyous occasion. And hey, Chris Brown, usually the point of having a featured R&B singer is so he can do something that the main artist can't do, namely singing, and you're kinda doing the thing that Busta Rhymes can already do, so why are you here? Also, half of your video is an abandoned building in an old mattress. Is this your version of having anything? Dang, your imagination sucks. I mean, dude, do something crazy in the video, like
you can see the conglomerate.
Yeah, like covering yourself in diamonds, or are you in front of Occupy Wall Street protesters? So in this video, you're protecting Occupy Wall Street protesters in a song where you say you can do anything you want because you have a limitless amount of money. I don't think you know what Occupy Wall Street is about. Whatever, I'm just glad I'm doing an episode of this show where I'm not talking about a member of Young Money. What? Busta Rhymes just signed a Young Money record? Son of a bitch!
Maybe we be my corona line, and I will be your main squeeze.
Oh, that was lame. Hey, wait, did you just give away the punchline with that little pre-echo there? Was it just so funny to you that you had to have a little foreshadowing there, like people are gonna listen to the song and go, oh, why did he say corona, why did he say main squeeze with a dog? Oh, that's why he said it, because it's a bad punchline.
And if your brother don't like my style, we can take it to the street.
So you want to be with this girl so badly that it shreds your inhibitions concerning corny metaphors, but if her brother doesn't like his terrible wordplay, he's gonna catch a beat down.
How romantic.
Indeed.
I'm at a payphone trying to call home. All of my change I spent on you.
First of all, John Cusack, what decade are you in? But this isn't about him. This is about Wiz Khalifa. And I have a serious issue with him as a rhymer. See if you can guess what it is.
Man, fuck that shit. I'll be out spending all this money while you sitting around wondering. So you talk about who you see at the top or what you could have saw, but sad to say it's over for. Now it's me who they want, so you can go and take that little piece of shit with you.
He barely rhymes anything. You know, this is a very basic concept, and it just seems like he's going out of his way to not do it. He might as well just say, this is the first line of my song, but I couldn't think of anything to rhyme with it, so I'm gonna speed up my cadence until I get to the next line. But I can't think of anything to rhyme with that either, so I'm gonna speed up my cadence. And he's done this before. I've heard him do it on numerous songs. In fact, I bet right before he recorded this verse, someone tried to tell him, okay, Wiz, we're gonna need a catchy rap verse from you, so we're gonna have to ask you to rhyme at least a few of these words. Could you do that for us? Khalifa's response?
Man, fuck that shit.
I'm the rap critic. You don't have to like my opinion, but I don't have to like your song.